This is the second video in the eco-friendly wireless charger series, and in this video we're going to take a look at how to build a cardboard mock-up of the wireless charger.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. This video is also dedicated to TeamSeas.org, where we're trying to raise $30 million to remove 30 million pounds of plastic from the world's oceans. So head on over to TeamSeas.org to make your donation today to help save your beautiful planet. Link below in the description.
In the first video, I built a paper mock-up to understand the scale and the size of the product. And in this video, the purpose of this mock-up is to understand manufacturing and assembly and to attach the wireless charging ring on the inside and work out all the details before we go to make a final pulp molded prototype.
In the paper mock-up you see here from the first video in the series, I don't like the proportions. They need to be adjusted. So I'm going to work on that via some sketching tools before I go to actually build the cardboard version. Additionally, it has a visual flow problem, so I flip around the back support to try to address that issue. So many of you are saying, well, why build a cardboard mock-up at all? It's really important that you have hands-on time with your design and what it is that you're working on. Building a model gives you that hands-on design time so that you can see the proportions, feel it in your hand, make sure it feels right. You just cannot get that when you build something in CAD. So for me, I like to build my stuff and be really sure and confident about the proportions and the functionality of what it is that I'm making before I go to CAD. You saw me use the original paper model as reference, and I measure off of that, make adjustments in scale and dimensions from that model, and then I go and build my pieces out of the cardboard. This is a chipboard. It's very cheap. You can buy it anywhere. It's around this point of the model where I realize that I have a potential issue. I have these like kind of outriggers on the bottom, and this is where I realize it's just not going to work. There's a molding issue and there's an undercut issue, so I can't make a pulp mold that way, and I can't pull it out of the mold with any reasonable repeatability for production. And so I simplify the base here and we make it like the other parts, where it's a simple straight one piece pull. And it's going to make it a lot easier for manufacturability and for us to prototype as a pulp molded product. It's important to not confuse this with a folded cardboard kind of model. I make all the pieces individually and then I glue them together. You would be tempted potentially to make this out of one piece of cardboard and possibly laser cut it and fold it all together. But this isn't that kind of a model. I'm trying to simulate a pulp material or a cardboard kind of material. So I make all the pieces separate and I glue them together individually. Now that I'm done with the base, I'm trying to build the main support. This is the support that holds the cell phone in the upright position, and I'm trying to make it in one piece if possible. You may be tempted to do that, but it's really not worth it. It's difficult to do, and ultimately this is not a folded paper product. So while you get some additional strength, you don't really get any efficiency gains in terms of building the model. It's totally okay. Build it in separate pieces. It'll actually be faster and it'll make things a little bit smoother for you to figure out and for assembly as well. I'm using some white artist's tape here, and this works well to hold the pieces in place while the glue dries. I'm using a white glue. It's a PVA standard. It's nothing special. Now that I'm done building the front support, it's time to build the back support. You'll notice I'm building each one of the sections individually, and then we'll come back later and we'll assemble them all together. I want to point out it's important to change your X-Acto blade often. You want a really sharp blade here. To use a ruler, make sure that you cut on the side that is the waste side, so that if you accidentally slip, you don't destroy the piece that you're working on. make sure that you use a steel ruler and not a plastic ruler. The plastic ruler you can cut into with your knife. And you also notice possibly that on my ruler, I actually remove the cork backing because I want to get the ruler right tight up to the surface of the cardboard. And I don't want that extra space in between the ruler and the cardboard so that I can get a good cut instead of having a wavy cut. Now that all the pieces are made, I'm going to use a piece of Bristol board to put the separate pieces together. You'll note I make a score cut at the hinge so that I get a good flexible hinge but still have some good strength. I just use some PVA and then I use my fingers to press the pieces together. So we have two of the pieces put together. This is the front and the back support. We'll put on the tab here to connect it to the bottom base. First, we'll remove the tape since that's dry and it doesn't need to be on there anymore. And we got the strength that we need. I've attached all three pieces together. And one of the remaining issues to solve here is how to tab that front surface together to the base and to get some good strength. So I'm just gonna cut some slits and leave about maybe 4 millimeter overhang so that we can slot that bottom piece into the base. And I'm just working out how much to cut away and how big to make these little tabs. And I need a little bit more additional room. And I just remove some with the X-Acto so that I can slide that support piece into the base. Banggood has been gracious enough to send us a wireless charger for this build. I will put an affiliate link to the Banggood website below for the Blitzwolf wireless charger. It's USB-C, of course, and it charges Android and iPhones without any issue. It's also magnetic, so it kind of snaps to the back of your phone, and that's kind of a nice feature to have to keep your phone centered on your charger. I take some measurements because I'm going to need those measurements a little bit later on when we go to build the CAD model to make the molds for this. But for right now, let's try to thread the cable through and see how this kind of fits. Ah, look at how nice that fits. This is no accident. I did know that I was going to use this charger from the beginning of the project, of course. Let's cut about a 7 millimeter strip here, and we're going to use this as a ring to help us attach and insert the wireless charger from the back. I use my finger to kind of help smooth and roll the cardboard into a circle so that it can form around the charger. We'll use a little white glue. I'll mark the spot, and then I'll just hold it together while the white glue sets up. And we'll just wiggle it back and forth here to get us something that's pretty tight around the wireless charger so that we can have a good snug fit so that we can hold the charger in place on the back of the mockup. I'm going to use a little bit of white glue here to glue the ring in place. I know roughly where it needs to be so that it falls into the middle of the phone so that it can charge correctly. We'll place this in place. You'll note that I have the overlap at the bottom. And this is so I can come back for this reason right here and cut that overlap away. And this is where the cord will hang down. Let's test it out. Put the charger in and that holds it nicely in place. We'll thread the cable through and we'll test it out. In order for me to build some molds to form the screen to pulp mold this, I need to build this in CAD. And I take a side view of the cardboard mockup and I pull that into Fusion 360 and I use that as my guide to create all my surfaces to build the basic geometry of the part. This really isn't a fusion tutorial, but just to cover the basics, I'm basically building half of the model and then we'll mirror it over on the other side. You'll notice that I have these flat surfaces outside of what the model is, and that is to build the molds, because that's the purpose of this CAD, is to help me build those molds for the screens so that I can pulp mold this. And we're gonna do a little notch out here for the cord, and you're gonna see this start to come together. We'll mirror everything over. Now we'll build boxes around everything so we can build a top and a bottom half mold and put the screen in between it and squish the screen to form our mold so that we can pulp mold this. Don't forget to head over to teamseas.org, make a donation to help pull some plastic out of the ocean. In the next video, we're gonna take a look at 3D printing the molds and forming the screen mold so that this can be pulp molded into a realistic pulp molded prototype. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.